Hey guys, I'm Nate. We are back at the Dome, and once again, we want to try an experiment with molten salt. We're going to try pouring it into a watermelon, a cantaloupe, and then just a bottle of fruit juice. To be able to pour salt into our watermelon, I've got a 1 1/4 inch spade bit. I'm gonna drill a hole about halfway in, pour out the extra juice, and then we should have a nice little channel that our salt can land in. To make it just a little bit easier to aim the salt right down into the hole, I'm also gonna use a little knife and carve a sort of funnel shape into the opening. All right, that should do a pretty good job of directing our salt right down into the heart of our tiny little watermelon. Now let's try the same thing with the cantaloupe. Of course, a cantaloupe is a lot more hollow on the inside already. It has a lot of seeds in there, but it's not solid pulp all the way through like a watermelon. With our watermelon raised up right here, we should have the salt pour out nicely down into the gap. Hopefully that'll really fill it up with salt. And if we're lucky, we'll see an exploding watermelon. The salt is nice and molten, so here's the plan. I will turn off the furnace, I'll take the crucible out, put it into the steel cup, and then I'll back away a safe distance, pull the string, and hopefully all that salt will be poured right down into our watermelon. Let's give it a shot. 3, 2, 1. Oh, that just exploded immediately. Oh boy, that was great. I think just the second that the salt hit the watermelon, it was already breaking open. You can see why it's still that hot, glowing orange. That was some toasty salt. Well, there's half of our watermelon, and there's the rest of our watermelon. That just tore itself wide open in no time at all. Turns out watermelons don't get along very well with molten salt. Who knew? All right, our cantaloupe is ready. Now we're gonna do the same thing. Salt will go in the pouring device, we'll secure it in place, we'll pull the string, and maybe we'll get an exploding cantaloupe. 3, 2, 1. I think it missed. Not all of it, but a lot of it. Then a cantaloupe also has a whole lot more empty space inside it than a watermelon. I mean, it's steaming. Clearly a lot of the salt made in there. See some of the salt poured off? I think it actually hit the cantaloupe and spilled off the back onto the wood here. Yep, we had some salt running down the back of the cantaloupe. We definitely got salt inside it. I think we have to crack this thing open and see what it's doing in there. That's kind of cool. Look at that, just filled in some of the gaps. That is weird. Formation. Yeah, that's pretty fun right there. So we did get a good amount of salt that went right into the cantaloupe, just like we wanted it to. We didn't explode, and I think that's because the cantaloupe has a lot more of a cavity than the watermelon. So when there was a little bit of pressure built up in the watermelon, it had nowhere to go, and so it just exploded. But the cantaloupe had enough space in it that it was able to just let all of that suddenly forming steam escape out the top. I've never smelled burning cantaloupe before. Well, I've got one experiment left, and it's not technically pouring salt into a fruit, but it is pouring salt into some fruit juice. I'm just gonna cut the top off of this container and see if I can get molten salt to fall down into the juice. And I'm hoping for like a geyser of juice or something like that. Thank you. Three, two, one. Oh, that's pretty great. Whew. Super hot crucible. And there's our steel cup with some still glowing orange molten salt at the bottom of it. All right, our juice container, largely untouched, which is about what I thought.
Mostly I was just kind of hoping for a fountain of juice to launch up, and I think we got that pretty well. Juice or salt, whichever one was launching up into the air, it worked pretty well.
I think the watermelon definitely gave us the best results. As soon as that liquid salt hit the inside of the watermelon, that thing exploded open. It looked pretty great. Pouring it into the cantaloupe, we got a lot of steam out of it, but I think because there was a hollow in the center, it didn't have enough pressure to really tear anything open. We got some interesting cast shapes out of our salt, that's for sure. And then pouring the liquid salt into the juice didn't really give us any sort of rupturing effect, but we did get kind of a nice spray of salt into the air. It sounded like an explosion, and some of our juice definitely went flying. I think everything is covered in juice right now. I'm curious if it's salty juice. Yeah. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you're not a subscriber yet, just hit the bomb to get in the club. If you missed our last video or want to see it again, click up here at the top. Click down there if you want to see what the internet thinks that you should watch next. That's it for now. Have fun, be safe, and see you tomorrow.